Welcome back to Design Bundles YouTube channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Crystal. Today, I have a fun project for you guys and a beginner-friendly one at that, or even if you're a pro, it's one you're going to love. Today, we're going to do a DIY reverse canvas, and we're going to be using HTV for this. So here, I just have a blank canvas. Normally, you paint on these, but today, we're going to create a sign with this. So what's really cool is it has our wooden frame hidden right inside of here. We are going to take this off. I have a 10 by 10 that I'm using today, but you could definitely even use all the way down to like the 5 by 7. They make really small ones, really large ones, whatever you want to do. So what we need to do is we need to measure the inside here because this is the direction our frame is going to be. So even though this is a 10 by 10 frame, keep in mind on what you want your sign to be, because technically I've only got about a 6.5 by 6.5 frame from a 10 by 10. So that's one of the things to keep in mind. The really cool thing about this project is you can usually find these at the Dollar Tree for a buck. You can grab them locally. We have some link down below for you guys as well. And some places you can even get them in a multi-pack to save some cash. Now, there's a few different ways that you guys can do this. You can use a staple gun like I'm using today. It makes it so, so easy. Or you can even use push pins. You can put those in there. But you can complete this entire project from the Dollar Tree. You can even use hot glue if you want to. So if you want to see more tutorials on this using the thumbtacks or the hot glue, make sure you guys drop it down below and we will do that for you. We also have more of these tutorials here on the channel, so make sure you guys definitely check those out by simply typing in reverse canvas and you should see those. So going over our supplies today, we have our reverse canvas. And like I said, today I am using a 10 by 10. We are going to be using HTV for this project. I like to use HTV over adhesive vinyl because it's going to last a lot longer. And we are using this really pretty, this is an olive green. This is Caesar Easy Weed here. And then I'm using my blue mat. You can definitely use your green mat as well. So I've got those there. We're using the Cricut Explorer 3 today. And then you could definitely use your Cricut Explorer 2 for this project. I've got a heat pad here. I could have got away with a smaller one, but this is what I'm using. And then today we're going to be testing out this project. These using the little mini irons, you could definitely use your bigger 9x9, 6x7, your bigger heat press just like this if you want to. But today I'm going to be using a little mini craft one like this if you have your Cricut one. But this one is the HTV. I never know how to pronounce this one. Is it HTV Runt? So this is a brand here. I have it linked down below. You guys can find these on Amazon. So I know we get a question all the time about how this brand is. So I'm going to put it to the test today. It just works the same as the little Cricut one. And you push the three dots. So I've never used it before. We're going to put it to the test. Comes with the same similar little base here. Like I said, it's linked down below for you. And then I am going to try something. So I get some heck sometimes for you guys, or you guys also even teach me some stuff. So I've had a lot of comments on our last reverse canvas about taking a screwdriver, because normally what I do is I take my Cricut, you can take a knife blade, any sort of knife blade, and a protective ruler, and you can just cut this canvas off. If you guys want to see how to do that, definitely check out one of our other tutorials. But I've seen a lot of comments from you guys, a lot of feedback about using a flathead screwdriver to remove these, because technically you only have four, for example, on this one, and it would be a lot faster than trying to cut it off. Now, I did not bring the flathead screwdriver, but I do have my weeding tools. And the one I'm going to sacrifice first is the one from the Dollar Tree. This may not be strong enough. We may not be able to use this one, but I may even try to use this one here from Cricut. But definitely, let me try it first. Let's see if it's going to work. You definitely don't want to tear up your good ones. Use a flathead or even probably a butter knife would work. But I don't have anything like that here in the studio. So we're going to try it out. And then if not, I may take a pair of scissors because I don't have my knife blade today. So you can also take a pair of scissors and use that blade to go over, like open it up. Just make sure you protect your hands from the blade. So those are some things you're going to need. I think I've went over everything. You may need a tape measure. You're going to need a tape measure to measure the inside, like I said, so you can figure out the dimensions. And I think that was everything we need. So let's go ahead and dive into this. So let's go ahead and start by taking off our canvas. Number one, I'm going to try this. Like I said, let me try to sacrifice my weeding tool from the Dollar Tree. I think it's too flimsy. I'm not going to do it. All right, let's go into the Cricut one and see. Because basically, I just need enough to get under here. Oh, it looks like it's going to work great. All right. Now, I've never done this, and then I want to see how it's going to work, taking this completely off. like I said, I almost poked myself big time there. But what we're going to do is I'm going to try to wiggle this guy. There we go. So, hey, thank you, thank you, thank you for you guys that have left the comments on using a you know, flathead screwdriver, but definitely you can use your weeding tool, and it seems to be working out great. So I'm getting it underneath there, and I'm getting one side propped, and then I'm grabbing the other side. So it's working out great. And if it stays like the first two, it seems like you can wiggle them out pretty easy. So just like that, we have one more to go. And then this particular canvas, since this is a better quality one, and not that you need it, I just picked it up from our local craft store. I think it has like a little, it looks like it has like this little braiding here that kind of helps hold it in place. So I'm going to go ahead and get that out of there. Yours probably won't have it, but if it does, it has this little guy like this. You're just simply going to pull this guy out of here. All right. Like so. And we're almost there. There we go. And then our canvas should just pop right off. So this one was pretty simple. So I'm going to say I approve this. This is a lot better than using the Cricut knife blade. And I think this is the only way I'm going to do it from now on. So if you guys have watched our previous tutorials and you've made these, try it out. Try using your weeding tool, or preferably try using a flathead screwdriver. That way you don't risk your little weeding tool here, but I don't seem like I've had any issues with it. Now, some canvases come with more little staples than mine did, but now what's really cool about this, inside of each one is these little frames. So the side that we're actually now using is this. This is going to become the back side, and then this is our front, which this always was the back, but this is now our front. Now you can paint these. I'm going to leave mine this natural color because of the design I'm using today. You could stain them, you could paint them, whatever you want to do. Acrylics, you could use your chalk paints, you could spray paint them, all sorts of fun things with these frames. So it becomes this really pretty frame. I'm actually going to drop my camera down really quick so you guys can see. And as you guys can see there, see how it's got this really nice beveled frame on there? It is so cool. Now, depending on your liking, you may want to take some wood putty. You can always fill these in and sand it down before you paint. Say, for example, if you're going to be selling these or anything like that. So you can always come in here and wood fill any sort of, and keep in mind that each frame, each brand of canvas is going to be different of how they build theirs, but you may want to fill in and then paint. But I like this. I like the naturalness of it, and that's how we're going to use it today. So the way that this canvas is going to work now, what you need to do is flatten it. So we're going to go ahead and flatten it like so. Get some stuff out of our way here. And we'll be trimming off this excess later. So you're just basically going to get your little area here. So this is actually going to come on here like so. So what we're going to be doing is using that staple gun. And then this area right here is going to be our canvas. It's going to seem like the back of a wood sign. So we're going to apply our HTB to this. Now, once again, you want to take your little ruler here and figure out what you have to work with. So I know that I have about 6 inches high, six and a half wide, 6.5 high. So I'm going to go by that, probably 6.25 high, and then go from there and see what we can do with our design. So let's go ahead and head on over to Cricut Design Space so we can get ready to size out our design and get it cut out. All right, so now that we're over here in Cricut Design Space, this is the super cute design that I'm using today, very boho. If you guys are a plant lover, you're gonna love this one. And it is a one single design. So you could do this in all black. Today I'm doing it in that olive green. I think it'll be super cute. So we're gonna go ahead and size this out to the, see how it's high right here, 11. I'm going to go ahead and size this out to the 6.25 high. And there we go. So that's going to give me 3.38 wide. So I think I'm happy with this. I think it's going to look great. All right. So once you size it down, you're ready to go. We're going to go ahead and hit make it. And then I'm going to be cutting on the mat today. We're going to hit continue. And then I'm going to go ahead and mirror it right away because we are working with HTV. We're going to hit continue. Like I said, I am using Caesar Easy Weed. And if you guys are new to Cricut, all you simply have to do is choose Everyday Iron-On, which is right here if you have it saved to the favorites, or you can browse all material and you can search for that here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that Everyday Iron-On. Once again, it's going to warn you to make sure that you have mirrored because we are using HTV. So let's get ready, cut it out. All right, so our Cricut is ready. It's blinking, and I've got my blue mat. Like I said, I've got my HTV. I'm going to go ahead and load this on the mat. If you want to trim it down to size, you could definitely do that now. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to make sure everything's smooth. We're just going to load it in here. Hit the load button. It's going to slide all the way through here, and then it'll give us that flashing go button. In the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and pick up some of these things, get rid of these staples here. We no longer need those. So now I'm going to go ahead and hit that go button, and I'm going to let this cut out. So while this is cutting out, we could go ahead and I was thinking I could prep some stuff, but honestly, I don't think I can because I don't want to cut our canvas. You never want to cut your canvas until you get your HTV on there. That way you can line this up, line up your design and everything like that. You can staple it and then trim it off. That way you don't accidentally make it too short. But these reverse canvases are a ton of fun. They're very beginner friendly, like I said. So if you are looking for a project to make with the kiddos, or even just a fun project to make on a rainy day, or even if you're wanting to sell these for a business and throw these in like a farmer's market or something like that, these are a way to make a DIY sign. Now there's lots of different ways that you could, once we're done to cover the back, you could always staple a piece of cardstock all over the entire back or get some really thin chipboard or something like that, or almost like a cardboard. I think it's like, it would be like a lightweight chipboard, I believe. You could always do that as well and cover the entire backside of the canvas. There's a few different things that you can do to make a little hanger on the back. One of them is you can hot glue a Coke tab on the back if you want to, or you can even get the little hangers, professional little hanger looking things, and screw those in for somebody, especially if you're going to be selling those. But signs like this, the reverse signs, they're perfect for weddings. You can housewarming gifts, Mother's Day, even your own home, bathroom signs, kitchen signs, you name it. You can make all sorts of different DIY signs with these. But I love this sign here, and I thought it was going to be super cute. This sign right here would be perfect in a kitchen, a bathroom, living area, classroom, office, wherever. This would be a perfect one. Now our design is almost done, so I'm going to go ahead and let this guy finish up. So while I'm trying to decide, I think whenever, actually, let's go ahead and get it going now. Let's go ahead and start getting this guy ready. So we're going to put it on number 2. I think that's going to be hot enough for us. So we're going to test that out first. So I've got it on 2. Now the thing about it too, I'm going to go ahead and while this is finished cutting out, is I've got a piece of parchment paper because I am working with the canvas. I do not want this little guy to get on the canvas and leave marks. So I'll probably go ahead and use a parchment paper to protect my canvas. All right, so let's go ahead and hit that unload button. We're going to flip this guy upside down. We'll get this out of our way here. And then we'll go ahead and cut this out. All right, so let's go ahead and cut it out here. There we go. We'll get this scrap out of our way. All right, so let's go ahead and take our weeding tool here and do this. I'm going to go ahead and drop the camera down so we can weed everything out and go ahead and get this pressed up. All right, so we've got our cute little design. I'm going to go ahead and start weeding it. If you guys are also new, I highly recommend Caesar. It's my number one favorite. And then the StarCraft as well is super easy and beginner friendly. They're just so easy to weed and use as well. And then my next one would be the Cricut brand. Now, with the Caesar Easy Weed, I really think it is truly the most beginner friendly you're going to get, as well as the most professional. It's just definitely, you can always get it on sale, lots of different places. You can always find different promo codes and things like that. But it's just so easy. They have beautiful, gorgeous colors, lots of different things from, you know, your glitters, holographics, and things like that. All right. So I'm getting a little bit of static cling here. I'm like, get off me here. So as you guys can see these pieces coming through, it's looking pretty gorgeous. Let me know in the comments below if you guys are a plant lover and what is your favorite plant. Now, I also want to know, are you a plant lover, but you know that it's just not going to make it, it's not going to survive, so you have tons of fake plants, faux plants. I have faux plants, but I will say a dear friend of mine has supplied me recently with some plants. And I'm so excited. So I am definitely getting out there. I love plants, but when it comes to caring for them, I'm not the best. I've always been one that takes it to I take it to near death and then I bring it back to life every time. So You guys let me know if you guys are the same. I want to hear it in the comments below. All right, so we are going to go ahead and just finish weeding these out. So I'm going to go ahead and speed this up for just a second because there is quite a few of these little leaves here. So I'm going to go ahead and speed it up. All right, so there you guys have it. How super cute is this? I love the design. So, so cute. So let me go ahead and get all of these pieces out of our way, and we are going to be ready to go. Now, I believe our little iron is ready. You guys can see the little green dots there. And like I said, I have it on number two, so hopefully that should be good enough. All right, guys, so I was picking up my little scrap pieces, and sometimes, you know, on this little silicone mat, those pieces want to stick. Just had an idea. I had an epiphany. We're going to pick them up with our lint roller. There we have it. So last little remaining pieces. Boom. There you go. So if you guys have a silicone mat like me and your little pieces want to get stuck to it, pull up that lint roller and get that off of there. All right. So we are ready. We're going to go ahead and bring in our little Cricut pad here. And then we are going to, like I said, you don't want to trim anything away until we're done, because that way we don't cut ourselves too short. So we're going to go ahead and line this up here where we're going to have our canvas pretty much. And then I'm going to go ahead and get this guy down in here. So I'm just going to go ahead and center this up in here. Just somewhere about like that, because we'll probably adjust here in a minute when we bring this back in. All right, so we've got this down. And then I'm going to go ahead and bring in that parchment paper because, once again, I want to protect my entire canvas. When you're working with a smaller guy like this, we don't want to burn it. We definitely don't want to just keep this in one spot or it's going to leave little marks, as you guys can see. So you want to have constant motion. I'm going to hold down my parchment and just move this guy. Just constantly moving. Now, keep in mind, I'm not putting this on here to wash. We're not washing this. So we're not going to need as much time or, you know, flipping it over or anything like that, like we would with if we were using a Cricut Easy Press, because we are using something similar. And there's that brand in case you guys are wondering. But like I said, we have this link down below for y'all. And this is one that you guys can grab on Amazon. So far it seems good. The heat feels good. I was feeling the temperature down here. It feels right to me. So once again, you want to keep that constant motion. We do not want to leave this or it's going to leave marks on our canvas. So I'm just going back and forth, just warming it up. Now, remember, once again, we're not putting this on a t-shirt. So I'm going to go ahead and turn this guy off because I think we're done with it. We're going to give it 2 seconds to cool down. So I'm going to just give it a second. This is a warm pill, hot pill if you want to, but I was just giving it a second. And then we're going to go ahead and peel. It's absolutely perfect. But like I said, don't feel like you're doing this the same way you would a t-shirt, because we're not going to wash it. I dropped that, so you can go ahead and cut that piece out. So I'm going to go ahead and bring this up so you guys can see. I have no marks on my canvas. So if you guys are using a bigger Cricut Easy Press and things like that, you want to be mindful because it can leave those marks. Now, for example, if I was using my 9x9, I wouldn't be too worried because my sign is going to cover that. Same thing with a bigger press. But if you are using one of these, keep that motion going. It doesn't take but a few seconds. And that little press worked amazing. But I love this olive color green here. It is gorgeous. So I think it's going to look really cute too with this natural frame. I mean, look at it. So cute. I'm going to put this in my bathroom on a shelf. It's going to be so cute. All right, next steps. What we're going to do here is you're going to figure out where you're wanting this to be. So you're going to eyeball it and figure it out and say, okay, I want it to be here. What you need to do is you're going to hold it tight. See, I'm pulling on my sides here with my fingers and I've got this. We're going to carefully flip this guy over, keeping everything in place. And I'm going to go ahead and get a staple on one side. All right. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull across. So I'm pulling nice and taut. So I'm not over excessively pulling on my canvas, but I want it stretched out to where I don't have any, I'm gonna get my second staple, where I don't have any little bumps. So whenever I go to check this, I can look at it now just to make sure it's still sitting where I want it, or I'm gonna remove those staples. Everything still looks good. I'm gonna proceed forward. So I'm gonna go ahead and flip it back over and we're gonna do the same thing. So I'm pulling nice and taut on one side. And like I said, so that way we're avoiding having any sort of, what do you call it, like waves or anything in that canvas, like I said. So now we're going to go ahead and do the same thing, pulling on the opposite side here. we'll double check ourselves again just before we get too committed and too crazy. And then now you want to get one in all four corners. We're going to go ahead and do that. The staple gun just makes it so easy, but once again, you could definitely use hot glue if you wanted to, or even thumbtacks, the flat ones. And the thumbtacks, as well as the glue gun and glue sticks, you can also get at the Dollar Tree. I'm not too sure about a staple gun. I don't think so at this time. And I'm going to go ahead and pull this one back out because I got it too far off of my canvas. So it's really easy to go back in. All right, and fix that. We're going to get our last one. So I'm pulling it nice and tight, making sure everything looks good. So we're not buckling is my word. All right, there we go. Perfect. It looks great. So now we have this, and now we're going to cut off those excess sides. So we're going to go ahead and do this. What I like to do is you can go ahead and fold it and get a crease if you want to, but what you're wanting to do is cut it on the, so you don't want to cut it where it's overlapping here because you want to see it in the front. You want to have a little bit in the back like this. So that way, let me cut this. Don't go in too far. So for example, mine goes way back in here, the wood. So I don't have to worry about it seeping through on this side. Some frames, they're really skinny. So be mindful of that, of how far you're also getting on the inside. All right, so we're gonna use our scissors to glide right across here and trim off the excess. So like I said, this is a beginner friendly project. So much fun, so easy to do, that you can even do it with the kiddos. So much fun. All right, so let me go ahead and trim off this piece, and then we'll get our last two sides here. All right. Once again, you can see I'm just kind of staying inside here, so I'm not over the edge. All right. I'm just using my basic fiskers here. This canvas. Now there's even black canvases, so you could do those where it looks like a chalkboard, and you could do white HTV, which would be really nice. And we're going to trim that last little piece because I'm afraid I'm going to see it through there. All right, so you can't see any of that. See how I can't see any of that? But look at that. Is that not amazing? It is so cool. But like I was telling you, if you don't like the way that this looks on the backside, you can then take and cut down a piece of either cardstock, or what I would use is a lightweight chipboard. It would be similar to what a cereal box is made out of. You can pick those up locally. I'll try to link some down below for you guys, but you could definitely cut that down to size. So this is a 10 by 10. I'd use my paper trimmer or whatever you need to cut that down. Then you can add some staples around that as well to clean that up. And then, like I said, you would take those little picture hangers and you can screw those on as well to make it look super nice. And then you can throw these into a farmer's market, sell them online, whatever you want to, or like I said, gift them to a friend, make them for yourself. I really love the naturalness of this, but once again, you could stain it, paint it, whatever you wanted to do. And there you guys have it. Is this not amazing? You could make them as big as you want to or as little as you want to. Lots of fun things that you can do. Lots of fun designs. Like we said, we have entire bundles for kitchen signs, bathroom signs, whatever you want to do. I really love it though. I think the olive green came out so nice on here with the natural canvas color here. And once again, this is a 10 by 10. Now, one thing that I do want to point out with this guy, everything else stays nice and cold, but I have noticed when I went to move my base that my base is super duper hot. Now I have never really, I guess, touched my Cricut base, so I'm not too sure if that's normal. I'll kind of try to test into that. But I think, and now if you guys have a little mini Cricut one, maybe one of you guys can sound down below if you guys know that's familiar. Because I mean, and there is a warning on there that it does get warm. My table's a little bit warm here, so I will say the base does get a little bit hot. That's something to keep in mind. But this guy has stayed really cool. It works really, really nice. And like I said, it's linked down below if you guys want to check it out. But also, this design is linked down below if you guys want to check it out as well. If you guys recreate any of our designs, any of our projects, please use the hashtag design bundle so we can check it out. And also, if you guys are not a member of our Facebook community group, definitely make sure you guys check it out. We have it linked down below as well. We do prizes over there. We have, that's where we have our dollar deals. We talk about extras and all the fun freebies and things like that. I believe we have promo codes, as well as you're going to see fellow crafters like yourself. We have hundreds of thousands of people over there, and they're crafting using our designs as well. Lots of inspiration, lots of answers as well. So if you guys have questions, people are getting to it like that. So definitely make sure you guys check that out as well. I hope you guys have enjoyed this. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe. And we'll see you guys on the next one. Bye for now.